Hey guys, what is up? It is Dan Lags, and welcome back to another tutorial video. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be building something that's really useful for both creative worlds and even survival worlds if you have the materials for it. I am going to be building a barn. So this is a barn design that I used on a builder's challenge video several months ago, and I know a lot of people that requested that I do a more in-depth tutorial on how to build this thing since it's a pretty cool design. I really like it a lot, so let's go ahead and get started with it. Some of the materials you're going to need are some quartz slabs, some spruce wood planks, red stained clay, pillared quartz stairs, oak wood, glass, fences, and some snow. We're going to need some other things as well, like hay bales later on. So let's just go ahead and start by placing the first couple blocks. So I'm just going to start right here and place one spruce wood block. And I'm going to take this down to the right 13 more. So we already have one, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, all right? So there's going to be the front of the barn just like that. Okay. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to take up 8 blocks of red stained clay right above the spruce wood plank on the far left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. That makes it 9 in total in height right there, which is absolutely perfect. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Just take this up and to the point where it is the same height. So a 9 block tall. Just like that, and that is going to be the front of the barn, so we're going to continue to work on that in just a second. What I'm going to do is take up another level on both sides here and here. We want to make sure that we don't fill this entire space just yet, because there's going to be obviously the doors that open up to the barn. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to make the barn doors to start off. So what you want to do for this is actually go ahead and get some pillared quartz blocks, and you're going to take this up approximately 6. So we already have 1, so we're going to go 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then what you want to do is take it across diagonal, or I guess horizontally, with the ability to do that with the pillared quartz blocks, just like that. And then you want to take it up on the other side as well to the same level, just like that. And then you can take it across on the top there, and then you can take it across one block above the other one. And then you can fill in that space there with some of the red stained clay. And there is our first of our two barn doors. So the way we're going to do this, guys, is we're going to have the barn doors, sliding open and closed. And we're not going to have them exactly symmetrical, because I think it looks kind of cool like that. They kind of look like they're in action, I guess you could say. So the next one over here is actually going to be one block away from the edge instead of two like we have over here. So I'm going to go ahead and take this one up the same number of blocks, 6 blocks like that. Then have it come across 2 and then back up 6 on this side, across 2. Go down 2, across 2 more, fill in that space just like we did for the other barn door, and boom. If you did this right, you should have 2 blocks of separation, I guess, opening to the inside of the barn. So what now you can do is you can come inside and you can actually just break all of the spruce wood blocks that connect up to the, you know, I guess the turn between the door and the actual wall itself, just like that. So that's a great start. We have the front of the barn already looking pretty good. So let's keep on going here. The next thing we're going to do is I'm going to take a red stained clay lining and I'm going to run it straight across right on top of the doors to there, one block off the edge of both of the 2x9 pillars, just like that. So it's going to be sticking one off the edge of this door and it's going to be right above the edge of that door. Next, we're going to take the snow caps that we have and just run them right across the top of this, just like that. And then you want to go ahead and place a fence there and a fence there so it looks like it's connected a little bit. And then lastly, you can take some quartz slabs and then run them right across the front just above the door. And there you go. You have kind of like the little, I guess that would be like the slider mechanism for the door. Perfect. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to take a red stained clay lining and run it right behind the snow caps. And you can also run them underneath of the snow caps as well right here. So you can take that lining across too. Basically, so it's just right above the doors and it's double stacked. So that looks pretty good. So next thing we're going to do, guys, is we are going to add the first part of the roof. So what you want to do for this is actually go ahead and place an upside down quartz and then a regular quartz stair, just like that. And basically, you're just going to kind of, I guess, stair this up, no pun intended, to the point where it can connect in the middle. And you're going to do this and connect them on both sides, okay? So if you do this right, it should be an odd number because we chose to make it 13 blocks wide at the bottom. So it'll create a one block opening in the middle once you get to the top, and then we can fill that in with a nice design. We're going to add some cupolas at the top as well, so that's going to be pretty good. All right, so I'm going to go there and there, And then obviously, like I just said, there should be one block of separation once you get to the top there. And all you want to do is just fill that space with an upside down quartz stair and then place a quartz slab on top of that. And you are absolutely perfect for this point in the tutorial. So what we're going to do now is all I'm going to do is just I'm going to go ahead and fill this whole space with red stained clay. And then we're going to punch out some holes for some stuff that we're going to add. So a couple of windows and a couple of other things as well. So we're just going to fill it in all for right now. And then we'll punch out the holes right after. So just like that, it's all filled in. And we're getting the front of the barn done pretty quickly here. So the next thing you want to do is go ahead and come one block above the, the snow cap red stain clay and break open a 2x2 space. And the way to measure this is to go one block away from the second upside down quartz stair. So the same thing goes on this side. So you're going to go right here, break that, one block away from the second upside down quartz stair. And then you want to just go ahead and place some quartz stairs on all corners like that to kind of make like a little small window. And then we're going to double stack that on the inside with some glass. So if we fly on the other side, we're going to place a 2x2 of glass behind that. And that's going to create just like a nice little barn window look. So something like that, right? Looks pretty fancy. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to place a quartz slab right there. We're going to punch a hole out above that and place a glass pane. So you just want to replace the regular glass with glass pane in your hotbar for a second. And then you're going to place another upside or another, slab right above that. Then you want to jump one block and we're going to place one sideways pillared quartz just like that. And there you go, guys. There's the front of the barn pretty much figured out. So it's looking great so far. So let's keep on rolling. All right. So the next number that you want to focus on is 9. So this was 9 blocks tall. So we're going to take it out 9 blocks more of spruce wood. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So as you can see, we have 9 blocks out on this side. We're going to do the same thing on this side. It's going to be very symmetrical. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You want to make sure you come one block in from this pillar right here. So that's looking pretty nice. And then what you want to do on this side is take it down 17. So we already have 1. So we have to take it down 16 more. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Same thing goes on this side. I'm not going to count it. I'm just going to try to, you know, line it up from a distance. So we'll just take it down and it's going to be lined up, I believe, is on this block right there. So these are kind of just like the dimensions of the barn. And then what you can do is once you get to the end here, you can take this back down to the same point. So 9 blocks. So that would be right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And you can do the same thing on both sides. Just take it all the way down so it's connecting across here. All right. So here are the pretty much the dimensions of the barn. And we're going to add this last opening here later on. But let's continue on to something else right now. So the next thing we are going to do, guys, is we are going to move on to right here. And what you want to do is actually knock out the corner blocks right here. So these four corner blocks, you want to knock these out. And what we're going to do is we're going to replace them with some oak wood. So I'm just going to go ahead and count up 4 blocks of oak wood on each corner. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And over here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then what you want to do on top of each one of those, you want to place a spruce wood plank on the 5th block, I guess. So you want to go all the way around like this. And now I'm going to focus on this side for a second, and I'll leave that side for later. So for this side, what you want to do is we're going to go ahead and place a quartz slab right on the edge of the spruce wood plank. And then you want to take another quartz slab and kind of run it around like that. And then you want to extend this out 2 blocks. So this is going to be 2 blocks away from the spruce wood on this side and only 1 block away on this side, right? So this is going to go all the way down on the edge like this and just run all the way down. And you want to run it 2 blocks past just like you did on the other side. And then you can have the spruce wood planks running straight across right here. And this is going to be kind of like a gradual incline on the roof. So we're going to go ahead and start that right now. Basically what you want to do is go every 2 blocks, okay? So something like this. Every 2 blocks, you want to go ahead and elevate to the next level. So, and obviously it needs to be a 2x2. So you just want to continue to take this up until it connects back to the main part of the barn. So it should be one more. And you want to make sure, obviously, if it connects perfectly for 2x2s, then you've done it correctly. And basically, you want this thing to connect right to the fence block there, pretty much. So if you did that, you are absolutely on the right track and you can continue forward. So now what we're going to do is just go ahead and, again, fill this wall in with some red stained clay. And by the way, if you're using a different texture pack, like the city texture pack, you can use red wool here instead because red stained clay might not look the best for this, but it's really up to you what you want to use. So just like that, we have this wall filled in. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump one block away from the oak wood here, and we're going to punch out another 2x2 window, and then we're going to do our same thing where we place our quartz stairs kind of lining the whole thing. And then we're going to jump two more blocks, and we're going to knock out three this time, and we're going to make the window like this on this one. So this one's going to be a little bit of a taller window like that. But on both sides, we are going to add some glass on the other side, because we're going to double stack these walls when we get to the interior in a little bit. So like this and like that. So there we go. That's what that side is looking like right now. So if you did this right, it should look a little bit something like this. It's pretty fancy. I like it a lot. So next order of operations is to go ahead and get out some spruce wood slabs. And I'm just going to go ahead and replace the fences right now, because we're not going to need those for a while. So what you want to do is place spruce wood slabs every other level like that. And then you want to place the spruce wood planks on the levels you didn't fill in already. So, and essentially you want the, the spruce wood to be kind of a half a slab elevated above the quartz on every level. And then all you have to do is just kind of just run it across to the other side and just make it exactly the same. Nothing else. It's pretty self-explanatory. Again, this barn is pretty simple to make. It's a really nice design. I like things in Minecraft that have, you know, they look good, but they're really simple to make. So this is one of those things, no doubt about it. It doesn't take a whole lot of, it's not that complicated, I should say. It might take maybe 30 minutes to build this thing. But, you know, it would be fantastic for a creative world if you want to add some animals or something, if you want to build like a farmland. And it's honestly probably even better for survival. You could have a really fancy, animal farm here. So it would be definitely something that I would love to build on Survival Island. I think that would be pretty cool. So filling in this last pillar right here to across there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add our slabs on this side as well. I'm going to do that real quick right now. And you can actually just go ahead and run them across right there on these. So that's a little bit easier on that one. And then you want to take this up like this, like that. There we go. And then just like we did on the other side, you just want to fill this in, and then we'll punch out the windows. So pretty easy. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the video to create the other side, because it's literally the exact same design, just copied to the other side, kind of just on the opposite. I kind of like mirrored it pretty much. So it should be really easy to just kind of copy this, what you've done on this side, to the other side. So once I finish up this side, I'm just going to cut the video and then do the other side real quick. And then we'll continue on to the back of the barn. So again, same thing like this, doing like we did on the other side, and then just fill in the glass on the other side. You don't have to worry about the glass sticking out right now, because like I said, we are going to double stack these walls. So don't worry about that. That's not going to be a problem in the future. And then finally, what you can do is on this back wall, you can just fill this in with some red stained clay. Just have this run across. So that's pretty much the plan, guys. So run this down to here and connect it just like that. And so last thing we're going to work on before I cut the video and do the other side is I'm going to run the stairs down on this side of the barn. So what you want to keep in mind with this number is 19. So we already have one here. So we're going to go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. If it's 19 blocks and you count it correctly, it should go one block off the spruce, just like it does on this side. And then you can just pretty much just connect this all the way down to the ground like this, and then make sure you place your spruce wood on the bottom. So we're going to run this all the way across over to here. Since there's not going to be a barn door on the back, you can take this up right here and then connect it back across to the other side. Again, 19 blocks, but it's already counted out, so you can pretty much just bring it right across, just like that. All right, so the next thing we are going to do, guys, is we're going to go ahead and create some windows. But first thing we need to do is run the stairs across. So we're going to run the stairs all the way down like this and make sure they'll go one block off. So they're pretty much lined up with the last slab here of quartz. And then obviously what you want to do is just take up the stairs and run them across and then connect them back to the middle. So it's pretty simple. Again, this is a simple build, but it's a great build though. And let me know, guys, if you guys want me to do some of the other things that I built on Builder's Challenge as tutorial videos, do like in-depth videos on them, because we have the Ferris wheel, I think is a pretty cool build, amongst other things that we could build for tutorials that, you know, I could go in depth on the Viking ship, the mage tower. So there's a bunch of stuff. Just let me know if you want me to do tutorials on that stuff as well, because it's a lot of really cool builds that would just kind of create add more detail to a world. So just let me know, guys, if you want me to do that. Because I really like doing Builder Challenge, and it's fun to kind of create things that I don't normally build. So the barn being one of those things. All right, so obviously, just like on the other side, when it connects to the top, you just kind of place the slab on top and the upside down's there. And you kind of have the perimeter of the roof pretty much squared away. So what we're going to do is we're going to add some windows now. So get out some glass, jump two blocks away here and punch a hole open right there. And then you want to just go ahead and place a glass block like that. And then what you want to do is, actually, you know what? Now that I think about it, this might actually be three blocks though. Let's see. I'm not 100% sure. Oops, I'm messing up right now. It might be three blocks away, so it might be right here is where you want to punch out the first one. Not 100% sure, but we're going to figure this out right now. One, two, three, and then it's going to go two. And then we're going to jump another three, one, two, three, and then another two. And then we're going to jump one, two, three to there. Okay, so it is only two blocks away. So I was right the first time. I probably shouldn't second guess myself. So basically, I'll explain this better once I have it all filled in. We'll just explain it better on the other side. How about that? All right, so like this. And like that. So that's how the windows are situated. Let's do this better on the other side. So basically two blocks away from the edge, you want to go ahead and place a one block of glass. Same thing on this side, two blocks away from the edge. Jump three blocks and punch two holes out. Place two blocks of glass. Jump three more blocks, punch two more out. Place two blocks of glass. If you do that right, it should be three blocks away from the other single glass right there. And you're looking great. So next order of business is to go ahead and grab some spruce wood stairs, and I'm going to go ahead and just get rid of the snow caps. We're not going to need those. And you're just going to run these across going all the way up to the top on both sides, and this is just going to be the roof of the barn. You can use any color block you want for the stairs. You can use oak wood if you're not in your snow biome. That's totally cool if you're building survival. You can even use oak wood in creative. I know it looks good with oak wood as well. I just personally like the darker colors of wood. I've talked about this before. It might even look good with birch wood even, so we'll see, it's just up to you, really. Or you just don't even use wood. You can use maybe like stone or something like that if you want. I just think, you know, wood and barns kind of go hand in hand, and it would be great if we had like red wood in Xbox Minecraft to kind of build with this. Honestly, it would probably look pretty good with acacia wood if you're building this on PC even, or on Minecraft Pocket Edition, actually. I'm pretty sure Minecraft Pocket Edition has acacia wood at this point. I hope it does. Yeah, it does. It does. It definitely does. So yeah, we're just going to kind of take this across here and have this go all the way up to the top. Again, very self-explanatory, having this run down. And as far as the interior goes on this build, guys, it's pretty simple. I'll do a little bit of it, just kind of help you fill in the walls and stuff like that. But it's really, really simple, so it doesn't take a whole lot to do the interior on this place. So we're going to run this all the way down like this. And then just take the slabs of spruce wood and connect them from slab to slab. And boom, there you go. So last thing I'm going to do before I cut is I am going to take some red stained clay, and I'm just going to fill in this entire wall here on the back. This whole thing's going to get filled in. And basically what you want to do is just take the same exact window, I guess, designs as you did on the front of the barn and just add them to the back. So I'll show you that in just a second here once we get this filled in, again, with the red stained clay. I really like red stained clay in the default texture pack. I wouldn't use it in the city if you're going to build in the city texture pack. If you're going to build in the natural, I think this is probably fine as well, using red stained clay. So there we go. And I think I just... I didn't. All right, so now what we're going to do is... well, first off, I'm going to go ahead and place the pillared quartz there. Place a slab there and a slab there. Punch that open. And that's going to be a glass pane again, like we had earlier. Like that. So right here, we're going to open up the spaces for the quartz stairs, like this and like this. And again, just like we've done the other side, it should be one block away from the second upside down quartz stair. And just like that, guys, we have the back of the barn pretty much put in, other than the glass on the other side. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the video, and I'm gonna copy what I did on that side to this side, and then we'll go in and work on the interior for a little bit. Okay, everybody, so hopefully you took that time to pause the video and create this side as well. Again, exactly the same as that side. So here is what the front of the barn looks like. It's almost done, guys. Still got a little bit more to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the two cupolas on the top of the barn. So that's the next step in the process. So let's get started. What you want to, I actually replaced the top level here with some quartz slabs instead of the spruce, so you can do that if you want. I just think it looks a little bit better. It kind of just lines the place a little bit better. So what you want to do is you want to come four slabs in like this and place a red stained clay on the side of that. So again, you want four blocks away from the edge, I guess you could say. And you want to do this on both sides. And basically what you want to do is kind of just break the stair underneath of it. And basically just take this across three like this. And then you want to have it come back up like that. So again, same thing on this side. kind of just make like a little U shape, pretty much like that. And then what we want to do is we want to break the pillar quartz there and there, place a sideways pillar quartz on each side. And what I meant to say, a quartz slab, break the quartz slabs and put sideways pillar quartz on each edge like that. And then you want to do is you want to go ahead and take out the redstone clay, three more blocks on each redstone clay block. So one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, and three, just like that. And then you want to go ahead and grab some glass panes again. You want to place two glass panes on each edge like this, and it's going to look really, really good. So just like that. And now what we want to do is get some quartz stairs and place three again on each corner. You don't have to connect them like this. Like, don't do that. I think that just creates a little, it makes it look a little bit too bulky. So just leave it like that. That's absolutely perfect. And then the next thing you want to do is go ahead and connect this around. You can actually connect these though. This is totally fine. So just connect some quartz stairs around like this, just like that. And then last thing you want to do is go ahead and place a regular pillared quartz block like that. We're going to get our fences back out. I'm going to go ahead and place, I guess, one, two, and three blocks tall of fence. And then on the middle one, you're going to go ahead and place an extra fence on each side like that. So the rooster will fly up there and go cock-a-doodle-doo in the morning, and you're looking absolutely great. So we're going to build another one of those, pretty much exactly the same on this side. We'll just do that real quick. So again, you want to do that U-shape like we were doing, the U-shape like this on both sides. And also, you want to do it four blocks away from the other edge. I think that's a given. Like that. So obviously four blocks away right there. And then of course you want to add your sideways pillared quartz. Make sure you break the quartz slabs as well. Then three blocks up of red stained clay. Like that. One, two, and three. Two blocks of glass panes on each edge. Then the quartz stairs are following after that. Like that. And then you want to go ahead and place quartz stairs again on each corner. Don't connect them on the edges. And then the next thing we're going to do after we finish this is we're going to do a little bit of detailing on the outside, and then we're going to finish up the video by doing a little bit on the interior. Not going to do a whole lot because it is up for interpretation. You can do whatever you want with it, but I will do a little bit just to give you guys some pointers. So last but not least, let's go ahead and add these fences again and put the fences on each side. So we have two chickens cock-a-doodle-dooing in the morning, or roosters. So here you go. There's the cupolas on the top of the barn. I just think that looks really good. That adds a great touch. So next thing we are going to do, guys, is I'm going to go ahead and grab some anvils and some bushes, and we are going to build some Danvil's anvils right now. So you can take this up three blocks on each side under right underneath the anvil like that. So it should be four blocks tall in total. And then what you want to do is grab some hay bales. And basically what I'm going to do is just kind of just like spam some hay bales like right up next to the barn door, pretty much. I think this looks really cool. This just kind of like adds like a nice, you know, barn touch or farmy touch to it. So you can kind of just take this up and pretty much put this in any order and angle that you want. Just kind of spam them though, place them all over the place. And that's going to look great. You could also add a kind of like a dirt road if you want, like just outside the front. Not going to do that in this video, but that is also an option. So something like that, right? Just kind of spam some hay bales like that. So that looks pretty cool. So we're going to move on to the inside, guys, and we are going to work on some interior. So I've placed a couple of placeholder blocks already. So what I did was, if you come one block away from the glass up here and then two blocks down, you want to place a pillar of oak wood. And then you want to come like one block up and then one block away and place another pillar that's one block shorter on both sides. And what I'm going to do, that's going to kind of mean something in a second here. But first, I'm going to go ahead and fill in some red stained clay above and below the glass that we have up on the sides. Like this. Above and below, guys. Just like this. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to fill in kind of double stack the walls, because that's another important thing we got to do. So we're going to double stack these walls kind of running across through here. This is going to go up like this. And basically, if you do it right, you want the window to be one block away from the edge right there, as you can see. So that's absolutely perfect if you have it like that. And again, we're just going to double stack on every single side. Also, we're going to double stack on the interior as well, or down by the other windows, I guess you could say. So again, just take this all the way up like that. And you don't need to fill in that space yet, because we're going to be covering that up anyway. Same thing goes on this side. So you just want to double stack it across right through here. And we're also going to add that glass as well, which we did not add just yet. So it, I think it's raining here on the world. That's okay because we're inside the barn. It's not a problem. All right, so there we go. So that would have sucked if that happened when we were still doing the exterior. But we're inside now, so we're protected from the rain, even though it is a little bit darker in here now. All right, so anyway, I'm going to grab some glass blocks again, just like this. Go ahead and place them on the four corners there, like that. So the next thing you want to do is go ahead and place a lining of oak wood running underneath of that red stained clay we just placed right below the glass. So like that, and just line that on both sides. And if you do that right, it should be right above the, I guess, the oak wood pillars that we placed right there. Next thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and fill in this space right here. Just take this right down. Just fill in that space just like that and just like that. Just fill in that space with some red stained clay. And then this space right in here, you can fill in with any block you want, but I'm going to use some spruce wood. So you're going to fill it in just like that. So it should be covering up the doors of the barn just a little bit, and that's totally cool. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we are going to place some, well, I'm going to break these blocks right here like this. And I'm going to actually add an extra block right there and an extra block right there. And we're going to place some upside down spruce wood stairs just like that. And also what you can do is you can actually break this in here and replace that with spruce wood if you want. Totally up to you, but that is also another option. And that's kind of like the entrance to the barn right there. That looks pretty nice. Next thing we're going to do is place some upside down. Whoops, that's not it. We're going to place some upside down spruce wood stairs running across right here. Right on top of those oak wood blocks, just kind of running right across there, like that, and have that go all the way in to there. So that looks pretty good. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is in between each one of these window openings, we're gonna take a pillar. So basically, we made these things three blocks away on purpose. So it basically comes up right through here, goes straight on through to the top, like that. And you, again, just dead center in the middle of each one of these things as we build this through a lightning storm, which is just so convenient, right? And then same thing on this side. Just break the blocks open right here and here and here. Oops, that's not right. Just like that. There we go. And again, all three of these pillars, you just want to connect them all the way up to the top here. Just like that. Okay, everybody, the rain is finally gone, so let's continue working on what we want to do. I was just getting too distracted by the rain to continue onwards. So anyway, guys, to continue what we were doing, we just finished these pillars. So what I'm going to do next is add some more pillars, but these are going to be horizontal pillars. They're going to come out from this top block of oak wood right below this pillar going across here, and they're just going to run all the way to the back of the building right here. And these are going to go on each one of these levels, connecting all the way to the back on both sides. And then what we're going to do is we're going to double stack the walls in here, and we're going to add a little bit of a catwalk second level of this place. And then we're going to be pretty much done with the tutorial. I want to thank you guys for watching. You know, this is a pretty cool build. I think it's pretty simple enough to build that, you know, you could do it in like 30-ish minutes and, you know, have something really nice for your world. So as far as double stacking these walls, all you got to do is just take some spruce wood and basically just kind of fill in everything that's open. Pretty much, it's pretty simple. Just kind of take all this space and just fill it in. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make these ceilings look a little bit better in a second here as well after we double stack this. So it should be all good. Taking this down and up and around like this. And yeah, we're just filling this all in. So pretty simple, pretty self-explanatory. Same thing on this side though. You just want to kind of take this across. So like I said, the last thing we're going to do on this build is we're just going to kind of create like a little second level balcony catwalk thing. You know, I guess you could just like store some things up there, like some hay or other things. But it's going to be pretty nice looking from the front. So that's what this is going to be looking like. When I first did this build, it was actually before the update where we got stained clay. So it was actually all red wool, but it looks a lot better with the stained clay, I think. So that's how they look with the double stack walls on the inside. And then what you want to do now is just take some stairs, some upside down stairs, and just kind of run them across right through here. You could take it above that as well, like that. And just have it run all the way across pretty much. Real simple. And I think you do that on three levels here. No, that's good. Just like that. So two levels, and then same thing on this side. Just so you cover up kind of that connection between the spruce wood and the red stained clay. because I don't really like that connection, and I think it looks just a little bit more gradual and better if you have the stairs here. So I think it's a good addition as well. As far as lighting this place, I just put some torches down right here. You can really do whatever you want with that. So up here now, we're going to do the roof, and what you want to do is just take some oak wood and just kind of run it right across horizontally like that. And then what you want to do is take some upside down spruce stairs again, take them across right through here like that, take them across right through here, just like this. And then you want to take them across right up here. So three rows of these right there, and it's going to look kind of like that. So it's going to go, it's going to kind of go stair and then two blocks and then a stair, then two blocks and a stair. So it's pretty symmetrical. I think that looks pretty good. So again, same thing on this side. Just take these upside down stairs and just kind of running them across. So yeah, not a whole lot to say about this. Just kind of do it. Run this across there. And you can take some lighting from the ceiling if you want. Like you can put some, I don't know, some like wooden chandeliers if you want. That's totally cool. And then what I'm going to do over here is double stack this wall so we can break that and just kind of double stack this. It'd be nice to get this kind of, it's going to pretty much be lined up to the other side, and so it doesn't kind of look awkward from those windows above. And this is where we're going to put that little balcony that I just mentioned. So kind of have this run through like that. And then what we want to do is take some upside down spruce stairs and run them across along these two oak wood beams like that. Kind of connect those across like that. Take some regular spruce wood and just run it right through here like this. You want to leave an opening in between here like that. And that's where there's going to be a ladder where you can climb up. I'm going to go ahead and grab some fences. We're going to place some fences right up on top there. And then the next thing we are going to do is go ahead and get some more oak wood and have it run across like that. Grab a ladder if you want one. Where are ladders nowadays? Here we go. Oh, that's a minecart. You can't use minecarts to climb this. So you just want to take ladders and just kind of run it right down through here like that. And then you can do another thing that we did earlier and just kind of like spam some hay bales, you know, right on the edge here next to the ladder on both sides, of course. Just kind of fill this in on this side as well. And you're pretty much good. Good to go. And I'll put one right there. Okay. So then, yeah, just like that. And maybe another one right there. Yeah, that's probably pretty good. So there we go. That looks pretty good, guys. And I think that's just about it for this tutorial, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Last thing you can do, obviously, I would say the best way to kind of divvy up how to, put the animals in is to take some, some fences across here. Anyway, we can break that. Take some fences across down the middle beam here and just kind of put fences on, or put animals in like kind of each one of these corners here. So what you can do is just kind of take another fence across right there. And then have like a fence gate opening right here, like that, maybe two fence gates. And then you probably also want to do that. That way the animals can't escape. So you can do that on pretty much all four sides. And you have like pretty much like four little openings for animals. And you can have horses and pigs and cows and sheep in here. It'll look really nice. So guys, that's pretty much it for the tutorial. Thanks for watching my barn tutorial. I think it's a nice looking build. Again, really useful for a lot of different worlds. Hope you guys build it, and if you do, send me some pictures on Twitter at my Twitter handle, at FPSDan, and hopefully I'll see some pictures of this. So guys, give it a like if you did enjoy it, if you found this useful. Might do some more tutorials for some of the stuff I've done on Builder's Challenge in the past, some future videos, but that's going to be in the future. So thanks for watching, everybody. It's been Dan Lags. I'll talk to you guys on the next one. Peace out.